Hi, this is Wasabi. Welcome to the channel. This is a battle on the Mountain Pass map, and we're playing in the new Polish 50TP prototype Tier 8 heavy premium tank. This is going to be the new Tier 8 premium heavy tank for the new Polish tech tree that's coming out in patch 1.1 soon. See that it's got quite a unique hull design and a unique camo style as part of the tank. The armour is reasonable compared to the Defender, and it's got a 122mm gun. So just see some of the characteristics in this tank. It's got good gun depression, about 8 degrees over the front of the tank and 10 degrees on the side, and about 4 degrees over the back of the tank. And what I'm doing here is just lining up pretty much in a fairly arty safe position and just taking a view through cracking the rocks. Just go forward to see how much of the tank is exposed. That also just shows you the pike nose. The underside there is actually not that strong, so we're trying to keep that covered. Take a quick shot on the T28 prototype down there and see damage 460 is related to the 122mm shell type. So it's got good alpha, very similar to the Defender. Just wait for that T28 to appear again. See, I had landed before and hit the VK100 behind me, but the position I'm in is relatively well covered from Artie coming over the hill that you can see behind. This top again. Now this time we bounce off, it wasn't that well aimed a shot, but he's taken a chunk out of the VK100. Anyway, the T10 has moved down, so we're going to go up and support him. Now Artie's taken most of the health out of that T28 prototype. He's put a shot into the T10. We're just going to keep pushing up forward, just being a bit worried about the Centurion that we've seen on the bridge. The T10 takes out the prototype. Now we're just coming further around the corner. You can see there's an AMX-CA tank destroyer. And we're actually going to put in a fairly quick shot. We do aim at him, but not completely. You can see quite good gun handling. So we're about having to wait for the gun to fully aim. It's a 3 second aim time without the GLD. It's about 2.8 seconds at the moment in place. But yeah, the T10's pushing up, so we're just going to keep going with him. Push around this corner. It's always a bit disconcerting, you don't know what's at the top of the ramp, but he is hit by Artie, and there's a Borsig who's pulled back out of cover. Now the trick here is to try and get as close to the ramp as quickly as possible. That way you're in an Artie shadow, can't be any Arty above, and basically the tanks at the top of the ramp have to wait for you to come up before they can take a shot at you, otherwise they can expose themselves. So you can see there's the T92 HMC Tier 10 Arty. It's got a splash damage in the game, I think, from memory. So I'm just a bit concerned about him, but yeah, well, I don't think he'll be able to get close to us while we're here. So just pushing up the T10 just to keep him, but I'm just going to go further, see if we can find the T92 and take him out just as we do that. Notice the Wheezy 111 1-4. So we're just a bit aware of that, but what we have noticed is the poor Zig has gone up to the top and taken a chunk, so we just spin right around, take a hit from the 1-4 as well as the T9. Chinese tank, and we'll just see if we can back up the T10 on this 1-4. Do some damage to him as well. So we do there, take a fairly quick shot, so you can again see the gun characteristics, not too bad. Time 61, not bad. Got a fairly long aim time, about 12 seconds, just over 12 seconds.
User disconnected from your channel.
Borsig's taken out the T10. And
User disconnected from your channel.
We're thinking we're going to be done, but we'll take the shot on the 292 and bounce a shot from the 111-1-4. So again, that sort of demonstrates the armor characteristics. I think partly that the it's a new tank and the other players don't necessarily know the weak spots of it. And we're going to bounce a shot off the 1-4. But I'm just a bit wary about going straight for him. And the rig is taken out by the rest of the team and we've done fairly well. So we're just hunting for the last party, but then we'll notice on the mini map he's way away, so we're just going to dive down here and see if we can pick up some cap points before the game finishes. So that's pretty much the game. Did just over our own hit points in damage. We did that by about 300 hit points. We ended up second on the experience table, which is pretty good. We were lower tier there. The other thing you can see from the battle results screen, for the amount of damage we did, made 64,000 credits, but you can see the shell cost is actually quite low for six shells, only cost 880 credits, so that's quite good. Repair costs there, we got down about 300 health, so it looks like a fairly cheap tank to repair as well, just under 6,000 credits to repair that tank. So all in all, fairly profitable vehicle. So of the six shots we fired, four all hit, but four penetrated, and that gave us that damage with a good alpha. We see it blocked 980, so quite reasonable. So thanks very much for watching, and see you again soon.